Dear students, now let's start with the topic of self-inductance. In this section, we are going to study various parameters of self-inductance. In later part of this topic, we'll study about mutual inductance and transformers also. But self-inductance is the basic fundamental of this whole section. So you must be careful in understanding. We already studied about the topic of electromagnetic induction. It is directly linked with the section of electromagnetic induction. About self-inductance, we can write that it is the property of a coil or a conductor by which or due to which it opposes change in current in itself. Whenever a current which is flowing through a coil or conductor changes, the coil or conductor itself opposes the change in current in itself. This property is called self-inductance. We can write that if there exists a current I in a coil or any closed circuit, then we can say magnetic flux linked with the coil due to its own current is phi, then we can write this phi must be directly proportional to the current flowing through it. Because we already studied that whichever magnetic induction is produced by the coil, that will be directly proportional to I, and the flux is directly proportional to magnetic induction. So we can always write the magnetic flux which is linked with the coil itself due to its own current will always be proportional to the current. So here we can introduce a proportionality constant L. And we can write it phi is equals to Li. Here, this L is a proportionality constant which is called coefficient of self-inductance of coil or coefficient of self-induction of the coil. Now here we can say if current in coil changes at a rate I dot, which is di by dt, then EMF induced in coil due to change in its own current is, this can be written as E, which is mod of d phi by dt in magnitude, which can be written here as L multiplied by di by dt in magnitude. Direction we are not talking about, because we know the direction of EMF is always such that it will oppose the causes of induction, which is here the change of current. So this EMF will be induced in such a manner that it will always oppose the change in current. And this EMF which is induced due to change in its own current is called self-induced EMF. And always you can write it opposes the change in current in coil. So mathematically it can also be written as E is equals to minus L di by dt. In some books you can find it also, but here we are talking only about the magnitude of self-induced EMF. Now in continuation, let's understand the concept of self-induction with the help of some realistic situations. Here you can see there is a circuit in which there is a straight wire AB connected to a battery of EMF E and a resistance R along with a galvanometer. Here we close down the switch, you know well that the current in the circuit instantly will rise from 0 to E by R, and you can see the galvanometer deflection will also change instantly from 0 to V by R. This is a normal circuit condition. But if we have a look on this another circuit in which in the wire AB we have given a turn and a circular coil is made. In the situation when the switch is closed, you can see the current starts flowing through the wire as well as through the loop also. And due to this, we can see in the wire AB, a magnetic field is developed in its surrounding in form of a concentric circular magnetic line of forces. And as the magnetic flux increases with the rise in current, you can see in the circular loop, according to Lenz's law, to oppose the change in flux through the circular loop, a clockwise current is induced. And you can see this current is in opposition to the current supplied by the external battery. So due to this opposite current, current will not instantly rise to E by R. Here you can see that gradually the current in galvanometer is rising. As it increases and approaches to E by R, the current in the circuit becomes constant, due to which the magnetic flux also becomes constant. And when the flux becomes constant, you can see the induced current will vanish, because in the coil, current is induced or EMF is induced only when the flux is changing. So here we can see, if we just draw the variation of current in the circuit with time. In the first circuit, we can see if the switch is closed at t equals to 0, instantly it will rise to E by R because there was no opposition. But in the second circuit, we can see as the opposition of the circular loop was there, here we can see the current will not instantly rise, it will gradually rise and approaches to E by R after some time or in an asymptotic fashion. But once it is approached to E by R, then no EMF will be induced in the circular loop or no opposition will be there, it will thereafter remain constant. See, instead of one loop, there are more than one loop, the opposition would have been more and the slope of this graph will further decrease as opposition is more. So we can say, self-induction of a coil or a conductor depends on its shape and orientation of flux linked with itself.